from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. We are all virtually being transported from our current locations around the great state of California, specifically beautiful Southern California, to the place where we are going to make history for our country by nominating and working our butts off to elect the next president of the United States, Joe Biden, and our own senator from California, Kamala Harris. Biden-Harris 2020. With all our hard work, we will also win majority Democratic control of the U.S. Senate and expand our Democratic majority in the House of Representatives. And now it's pedal to the metal. Go Democrats and go USA. Now, before we begin, please make sure that your Zoom is set to speaker view. Most of us have been doing Zooms now, so we know how to access the controls. So at this time, before we head into our pep rally, make sure that your Zoom is set to speaker view. And now, let's kick off our pep rally with representatives of the Wisconsin Democratic Party who are having a lot of fun in Milwaukee, eating cheese curds, brats, and some good Wisconsin beer, introducing some real cheeseheads, Trudy and Jeff Oped.
Hey, I just want you to know Milwaukee is really known for a lot of other things. We have fantastic theater, we have great sports, concerts, and the best festivals all summer long.
And we're excited about the convention, and we look forward to everybody being safe so that we can attend a World Series in Milwaukee.
Woo! Go Brewers!
Oh, that's fantastic. Thank you so much. Live from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Jeff and Trudy. Yes. And now, let's hear from a great Democrat, John F. Kennedy, at the 1960 Democratic Convention from Los Angeles, California, giving his acceptance speech. Take it away, President Kennedy.
Under any circumstances, the victory we seek in November will not be easy. We know that in our hearts. We know that our opponents will invoke the name of Abraham Lincoln on behalf of their candidate, despite the fact that his political career has often seen the show charity towards none and malice for all.
Thank you, President Kennedy. Now, our first speaker is pretty amazing. Her name is Ada Briceno. Ada has dedicated her life to becoming a social change agent. When she was six, her family fled civil war in Nicaragua for a new life here in the U.S. She started work as a hotel clerk and became the first Latina president of Local 681 by the age of 26. She is the chair of the Orange County Democratic Party, known as the DPOC, and Orange County's newest member-elect to the Democratic National Committee. Way to go, Ada. And this is her first convention as a DNC delegate. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to introduce Ada Briceno.
Say what you want to say, let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you, baby. What you want to say, let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you, baby.
Hi, Democrats. It's great to be here. Thank you, Dennis. It's so exciting to see what's going to happen in Milwaukee. And I'm so excited to be here with you and can't wait to hear from Dan Weitzman, Congressman Ted Lieu, Melissa Fox later tonight. Thank you so much for having me. I love the walk-on music about being brave. Don't you love it? That's what it's really about. It's about being brave. Melissa Fox is brave. She's tenacious. I admire her for standing shoulder to shoulder with the women and men in my union who take on million-dollar corporations. Melissa stood for low-wage workers to confront sexual harassment in the workplace at the Irvine Marriott. She stood strong to call for better health care and wages. And when she stood up, she made our workers be brave. And that's the kind of leader we need. Melissa Fox is brave, but also pragmatic. She's practical. When it comes to thinking of others, she puts herself last. She's the first one to recognize an injustice and calls it out. Because being brave is practical, and we can get things done. I admire Melissa for being brave enough to say no more. No more to weak lip service of the 68th Assembly District has suffered already for way too long. During this pandemic, he has done nothing for essential workers, for teachers or others who are struggling to put food on the table, to pay rent or the mortgage. He will do nothing about our looming climate crisis because he's made it clear that he does not believe in climate science. For our climate, for our economy, for our health, it's clear we must follow Melissa's lead and be brave. So I want to push you today. How will you meet this moment, and how will you be brave? In the 68th Assembly District, Democrats are so close to overtaking the Republican voter registration. We just need 1,322 more registered voters. That's only 0.5%. Did you just hear what I said? It's only 0.5%. For our down ballot Democrats who are working hard to flip seats in our cities and our school districts, we need Melissa. We need Melissa to help open those doors. She will get into the assembly and she'll help us get folks down ballot too. Politics in our cities are hard, but it starts with having an elected official in the assembly level to start breaking through how conservative our local leaders have truly been. And Orange County needs more voices in Sacramento. It's so important for Cottie Petrie Norris to have someone right next door to her who truly understands the issues we have here in Orange County. When Orange County schools and cities need partnerships from our leaders in Sacramento, we need local, we need brave voices at the table like Melissa. She has her ear to the ground and knows what we need. She's endorsed by teachers and many others because she knows how to fight for our school, for our children, and to get our fair share of the resources for right here in Orange County. We need leaders who can build strong relationships in Sacramento. And the current incumbent of the 68th, he can't do that because he's attacking our leaders at every turn. We need partners like Melissa Fox who can go to our statewide offices and get things done. Melissa has already built strong partnerships in Sacramento with leaders like State Controller Fiona Ma and State Treasurer Betty Yee. Melissa can put Orange County issues front and center. She will bring the voices of the 68th to every corner of the Capitol and ensure that our state is moving forward with Orange County at the table. So I ask you today, are you in for Orange County? How will you be brave? Melissa needs volunteers to get ready to jump in right away. We only have 82 days till November 3rd. It's coming right up on us. We're going to need all hands on deck. And I want to see you be brave. Be brave by making phone calls for Melissa. Be brave by donating further to her campaign. Be brave with Melissa and I. I'm all in for Melissa. And we're excited about the recent news with Kamala Harris. California is once again leading our nation, and we must meet the moment in history. Share in the chat if you're willing to join this campaign. If you are all in, I want to see you meet this moment. Please be brave.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, Ada. And now, a very special video of a very special time in American history. The year 2008, the Democratic acceptance speech by then Senator Barack Obama, accepting the Democratic nomination to be and would be President of the United States of America. Introducing the 44th President of the USA, President Barack Obama, and his 2008 Democratic acceptance speech. Take it away, Barack.
Change happens. Change happens because the American people demand it, because they rise up and insist on new ideas and new leadership, a new politics for a new time. America, this is one of those moments. I believe that as hard as it will be, the change we need is coming. Because I've seen it, because I've lived it, because I've seen it in Illinois when we provided health care to more children and moved more families from welfare to work. I've seen it in Washington, where we worked across party lines to open up government and hold lobbyists more accountable, to give better care for our veterans and keep nuclear weapons out of the hands of terrorists. And I've seen it in this campaign, in the young people who voted for the first time, and the young at heart, those who got involved again after a very long time, in the Republicans who never thought they'd pick up a Democratic ballot, but did. I've seen it in the workers who would rather cut their hours back a day, even though they can't afford it, and see their friends lose their jobs. In the soldiers who re-enlist after losing a limb. In the good neighbors who take a stranger in when a hurricane strikes and the floodwaters rise. You know, this country of ours has more wealth than any nation. But that's not what makes us rich. We have the most powerful military on earth, but that's not what makes us strong. Our universities and our culture are the envy of the world, but that's not what keeps the world coming to our shores. Instead, it is that American spirit, that American promise, that pushes us forward, even when the path is uncertain, that binds us together in spite of our differences, that makes us fix our eye not on what is seen, what is unseen, that better place around the bend. That promise is our greatest inheritance. It's a promise I make to my daughters when I tuck them in at night, and a promise that you make to yours. A promise that has led immigrants to cross oceans and pioneers to travel west. A promise that led workers to picket lines and women to reach for the ballot. And it is that promise that 45 years ago today brought Americans from every corner of this land to stand together on a mall in Washington before Lincoln's memorial and hear a young preacher from Georgia speak of his dream. The men and women who gathered there could have heard many things. They could have heard words of anger and discord. They could have been told to succumb to the fear and frustrations of so many dreams deferred. But what the people heard instead, people of every creed and color, from every walk of life, is that in America, our destiny is inextricably linked. That together, our dreams can be won. We cannot walk alone, the preacher cried. And as we walk, we must make the pledge that we shall always march ahead. We cannot turn back. America, we cannot turn back. Not with so much work to be done. Not with so many children to educate and so many veterans to care for. Not with an economy to fix and cities to rebuild and farms to save. Not with so many families to protect and so many lives to mend. America, we cannot turn back. We cannot walk alone. At this moment, in this election, we must pledge once more to march into the future. Let us keep that promise, that American promise, and in the words of Scripture, hold firmly, without wavering, to the hope that we confess. Thank you. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America.
Inspirational. Thank you, President Obama. And now our next speaker is Dan Weitzman. Dan is the controller for the California Democratic Party, a top Democrat fundraiser, and among the most influential people in California politics. But we know him as the coolest California delegate to the Democratic National Convention. I am proud to introduce Dan Weitzman.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much for letting me have this chance to talk to you today. Now, usually when I talk to groups like this, I do this as your controller, about fundraising. I talk about tips for activists, how to raise money. I talk about ideas. And, you know, the conversation is really direct, but it's light. It's always, you know, be magnanimous to people, be kind. You know, you never lose a contribution. You just postpone and all that happy horse shit that we talk about when we're trying to help people out. Well, tonight's a little more direct. Tonight's about our country's direction and our future and how we're going to right the ship of America. And closer to home, keeping Orange County deep blue. Not making it blue, keeping it blue. Now, the election of Joe Biden and Kamala Harris and the defeat, let's remember this word, the defeat of Donald Trump and Mike Pence is truly kind of a tale of, in my view, of two cities. One team has your back, the other wants to push us back. So let's examine some of the issues that, you know, we talk about, just a couple for fun. The rights of women's reproductive choice. Donald Trump wants to overturn Roe v. Wade. Yeah. Joe Biden wants to protect it, and he has your back. Social equality and respect for all peoples of color and race and sexual orientation. Donald Trump thinks our country's doing fine. He sees no problem. He asks that, in a racist tone, what about white lives? Why don't they matter? Well, Joe Biden looks at America and says, we can and will do better. Black lives do matter, and he will work with everyone to bring real equality to our country. Joe Biden and Kamala Harris has your back. Let's talk about something more close to home right now. COVID-9, the COVID-9 recovery, making sure all of us get through this horrible pandemic safe and secure. Donald Trump says, well, it's gonna go away, like poof. Remember that superlative? He called the China flu, he's failed to act, and critical resources needed to get this pandemic fixed. He has refused to do it. He won't wear a mask, and he kind of snubs his nose at over 160,000 people dying of this horrible disease. Well, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, they know better. They trust science. Wow, that's something interesting. He will pick up the ball on day one. He'll spend the resources to protect us, and again, he will truly have our back. So now we need to have their back. Joe Biden wasn't our first choice in a lot of us. Just remember that. Not all of us picked Joe first, but he is the only choice to save our future. You know, not to get too into this, but Donald Trump, he's kind of the grandmaster of hate, homophobia, racism, sexism, with a splash of Islamophobia, xenophobia, anti-Semitism, and let's not forget, if we ever had a moment to forget, misogyny. He is kind of, I call, the Dark Vader of America, and his plan for the next 4 years is more chilling than the Death Star. His vision of our country doesn't include us. It includes only people that look and talk and listen to him. Look at all the people he's fired. Good, smart, articulate people, even Republicans, and he got rid of them. We, when we elect Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, we'll bring back civility back to the White House, fundamental fairness back to the White House, not to mention heart. Have we forgotten about that? About real heart in our country and compassion? They will bring us a White House we can be proud of and an administration that sees us and includes us. The time is now to work hard to get them elected. And I say it's time to vote blue all the way through. I just made that up actually. 2020 is our chance to put a second coat of blue in Orange County and deliver on all levels of the Democratic Party. From waterboard to president, no Republican should be safe. Not one. We must stop them in the cradle and make our mark on history in 2020. When we and our children, and hopefully our children's children, look back on the fall of 2020, let the story be about redemption and salvation. Let us look back and say, this is what we did for your future to make sure that this horrible human was removed from public service. And we will do what we have to do to make sure he is removed, not because he's a man, but because he's a bad, bad man, as my daughter would say. So let's make history. Let's elect Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. Wow. I know all of us know her well. She's one of us, but to the rest of the world, they don't get to know all the things we know about her. And it's amazing. The first woman, person of color, API, on and on and on. Let's keep all our seats in Congress. Let's not only keep our Democrats in Congress blue, let's expand a couple. Let's get a couple extra for Speaker Pelosi. Let's reelect our supermajority, our super duper majority in the Assembly. And why not, just for the heck of it, let's flip the 68th. Why not? Let's get Melissa Fox elected and let's flip the 55th with Mr. Rodriguez. Let's do that too. But why not? And not that we would forget, because I know you might have forgotten, but we have some unfinished business in the 29th Senate District, right? I call it a repossession of a short-term rental for Josh Newman in the 29th. And we must elect Dave Min to the 37th Senate District. And on and on and on. Like I said, no Republican should be safe. This is our time. We need to deliver for all of them, and they'll be our champions. And as our champions, they will have our back. So let's make a choice today. Let's say it's time to rid this state and this country of the Trumpites. Let's elect Democrats and let's make sure that we, all of us collectively and all that can hear the sound of our voice, say once, we can beat Donald Trump. We can elect Joe Biden and Kamala Harris because they have our back. Let's have theirs. Thank you.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Dan. Very inspirational. Yes, let's go, Democrats. And now, the Democratic National Convention history, this next speech is historic and special. Ladies and gentlemen, our First Lady, Michelle Obama's 2016 Democratic National Convention speech. Take it away, Michelle.
With a record of public service, someone whose life's work shows our children that we don't chase fame and fortune for ourselves. We fight to give everyone a chance to succeed. And we give back even when we're struggling ourselves, because we know that there is always someone worse off. And there, but for the grace of God, go I. I want a president who will teach our children that everyone in this country matters. A president who truly believes in the vision that our founders put forth all those years ago, that we are all created equal, each a beloved part of the great American story. And when crisis hits, we don't turn against each other. No, we listen to each other. We lean on each other because we are always stronger together.
Yes, Yes, we are always stronger together. Thank you, Michelle. Our next speaker, well, he's the man, and our featured speaker, Congressman Ted Lieu. Ted represents California's 33rd district. He's a Stanford grad who majored in computer science. He got his law degree from Georgetown, joined the United States Air Force, and served in the JAG Corps. He currently serves as colonel in the Air Force Reserves. We know him best as Betty's husband and a champion for the environment, equal rights, civil rights, equality, and economic fairness. With pride and respect, a great Democrat, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Congressman Ted Lieu. Take it away, Congressman Lieu.
Thank you, Dennis, so much for the introduction. I'm going to have to tell my staff to do that same introduction for all my events from now on. But so thrilled to be with all of you, and I am so fired up. I am exceptionally pleased that Joe Biden picked my friend Kamala Harris as the vice presidential candidate. I was the first congressional endorser of Kamala for president, and she is going to be awesome as vice president. And I just can't wait for that debate she's going to have with Mike Pence. And I'm just so thrilled with the ticket. If the election were held today, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris would win. If you look at the polls, essentially, if Biden wins Pennsylvania, Michigan, and Wisconsin, nearly impossible for Donald Trump to win. Trump would have to flip a state that Hillary Clinton won in 2016, if that were the case. And not only is Biden ahead in Michigan, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, he is also ahead in Arizona and Florida. Biden's essentially tied in North Carolina and Texas. And we've got a shot in places like Alaska, who you wouldn't even really think of as a swing state. Biden's doing well in Maine. And so we have a lot of opportunities to expand the Electoral College. If you look at the Senate, same issue. We're doing quite well. Our candidates are ahead in Arizona, in Colorado, in Maine. We're also ahead in North Carolina, tied essentially in Montana, and we have a shot in Alaska. And if you look at the House, the DCCC just added an additional six candidates a couple weeks ago to a red or blue list to flip the number of Republican held seats to Democrat. And we know that with your help and support, not only we're going to take back the White House, we're going to take back the Senate and expand the House. However, the election is not tomorrow. It's in 82 days. So we have to keep the pressure up and make sure that we do everything we can to elect a Democrat ticket up and down the state of California and our nation. I'm so thrilled to be here with my friend Melissa Fox and hope all of you can support her as well. By the way, as an Irvine City Council member, she's very important because my parents live in Irvine. As a veteran myself, I just want to mention that the Orange County Register has said Melissa Fox was an incredible advocate for veterans, and she's the kind of person we need in Sacramento. Now, how can you help Joe Biden and House Democrats and the Senate and the people like Melissa Fox? Well, I want you to all understand your power to shape public sentiment. I think Abraham Lincoln had it right when he said public sentiment is everything. With it, nothing can fail. Without it, nothing can succeed. So for example, social media is free. If you write a post that resonates, maybe you'll touch a voter in Florida or in Ohio or in Orange County. Think about writing letters to the editor. It is true that many people do write letters to the editor. It's also true that many of those letters come from the same people all the time. So if you start writing in, then one day you'll get published as well, and you can start changing hearts and minds. And then think about, I know you're already going to do this, and are doing it now, volunteering on campaigns that you like, doing text messages, phone banks, making monetary donations, anything you can to make sure that voters do the one thing we need them to do, which is to vote. And let me conclude now by talking about that's a central element of what's going to happen in November. Many people are concerned, and rightfully so, about Donald Trump's sabotage of the post office. So I'm just going to tell you the truth. The truth is the House of Representatives cannot adequately fund the post office without the consent of Donald Trump. The only other option is to get the Senate to agree with us on a veto override. That's also not going to happen. So the best thing we can do is to spread the word that everyone who wants to vote by mail needs to vote at least 10 days in advance of November 3rd. And that's 10 mailing days. So I recommend that everyone vote by October 22nd if you're going to vote by mail. And if you can't do that, then drop that ballot off at any polling location. So I'm fine if you want to impeach Donald Trump again, but guess what? The Senate's going to stop that. I'm fine if you want to impeach the Postmaster General. Senate's going to stop that. I'm fine if you want to call for subpoenas. Senate, well, actually, not only that, the White House is not going to comply with subpoenas. Then we have to litigate it. That's going to take longer than 82 days. So instead of me promising you things that cannot be done in the next 82 days, I need everyone to accept reality and spread the word that if you're going to vote by mail, vote early. That is how we win. We overwhelm at the polls and we get people to vote early and vote by mail. And so with that, look forward to working with all of you as we have a blue tsunami this November.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, Ted. That was very inspirational. Okay, and now it is with great pride and honor to introduce a video that will pull at your heartstrings. This video will bring tears of joy to your face. This is a person who spent his life working to make our union more perfect at a time in America where you could be beaten and killed for peacefully demonstrating. He was beaten. He was held down, but he did not stay down. This is a man who has made the statement, "Get into good trouble," a mantra for our Democratic Party. It is with great honor that we play for you a special tribute made by our union brothers and sisters at the UAW, United Auto Workers, tribute to one, the only, the patriot, who we most recently lost in body, but never in spirit. The pride of America, the pride of Alabama, a person born in 1940, just outside Troy, Pike County, Alabama, the third of 10 children of sharecroppers Willie Mae and Eddie Lewis. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, the Congressman, John Lewis.
Into a thousand pieces, put them together in the image of God and democracy. We must say, wake up, America, wake up, for we cannot stop, and we will not and cannot be patient.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoice. The dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the
just give it all you got and not get weary be hopeful, be optimistic, and take the long, hard look. We had some difficulty. They would have some setbacks, but you cannot give up. You cannot give in. You will make it. They will lead us.
You up behind you a little bit.
Fantastic. Thank you, Congressman Lewis, for all you have done for our great country. You are a man of honor, integrity, grit, and love for all of us. And now, let's lift our spirits to see John dancing and having fun to the song Happy by Pharrell. That was awesome. Thank you, John Lewis. And yes, we'll keep getting into good trouble. And what is good trouble? Well, good trouble is your right to vote. We have 82 days until November 3rd, where Trump is going to be fired and the new 46th president of the USA, Joe Biden, is elected, along with Kamala Harris as VP. 82 days left for us to win Democratic control of the Senate and fire Moscow Mitch and elect Amy McGrath in Kentucky. And with Democratic control of the Senate and Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, we can give Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, that's right, RBG, some much needed relief and rest. 82 days to expand our Democratic majority in the House, 82 days to get women Democrats elected, 82 days to get Democrats into city council seats, 82 days to get Democrats into state assembly seats, 82 days to get Democrats from dog catcher to POTUS. Democrats are the party of the people, and this is our time to fight and win majorities across the board. And then with those majorities in power, we can do what Democrats do. We govern, we problem solve, we work for the people, and we make the lives of our brothers and sisters better using good government, our government, love, transparency, equality, teamwork. Game on, go Democrats, and go USA. Okay.
Okay, we are ready to do our favorite part of the program, which is we are going to take our convention photo.
Yay. Dennis,
can you walk us through how to take our photo?
Yep, here we go. So,
turn on your cameras, everyone.
Yep.
And switch to gallery view.
Photo time.
Give us your best faces. I have Joe Biden with me here, and I can't wait to get my new Kamala bobblehead.
So hold up campaign signs, any campaign gear, get close to the camera. We're going to take some photos, and then we're going to share the photos on social media. Now, the Democratic Convention, as you know, is taking place next week. What they want us to do is to hashtag all of our photos going forward to November 3rd with this hashtag, hashtag Dem, D-E-M, convention. That's hashtag Dem, convention. And then feel free to share that across social media so that the rest of the country can see all the fun that we're having here from Southern California, live Milwaukee, Wisconsin, so that we can share those photos across the country on our way to victory. So at this point, we're gonna go through a few of these titles that we have with multiple participants on the Zoom. So bear with us as we take these photos. Smile, everybody.
All right, everybody smile for the first one. All right, second page. Everyone smile. Perfect. Okay, did we get it, Allie? We got it.
Fantastic.
All right, back to Dennis.
Way to go. So we are making history and go Democrats. All right, and now I'm proud to introduce California's own VP picked by our guy, Joe Biden. Our California Senator Kamala Harris is an American lawyer and a politician serving as the junior United States Senator from California since 2017. She is a proud Democrat and is the second African-American woman and the first South Asian American to serve in the United States Senate. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing our own senator from the great state of California with 40 million residents here in California, from San Francisco to Orange County to San Diego.
Had a few spoons.
Senator Kamala Harris.
So let's talk about the current occupant of the White House for a moment, shall we? This is, but we must, it's context. This is a guy who came in on a campaign that was about looking backward. This is about a guy who came in and has been in office using the power of the voice of the President of the United States in a way that has been about trying to divide us, in a way that has been about trying to sow hate and division among us. But see, we know that one of the greatest strengths about who we are as a people is in our core, in our heart. We know we all have so much more in common than what separates us. So we're not gonna buy what he's trying to sell, because we know dude gotta go. Dude gotta go. So we are gonna fight knowing that we have so much more in common than what separates us. And the way I think about it is what I call the 3 a.m. thought. You know, when you wake up in the middle of the night with that thought that's been weighing on you? Well, for the vast majority of us, when we wake up thinking that thought, it is never through the lens of the party with which we're registered to vote. For the vast majority of us, when we wake up thinking that thought, it is never through the lens of some simplistic demographic some pollster put us in. And for the vast majority of us, when we wake up thinking that thought, it usually has to do with one of just a very few things: our personal health, the health of our children, our parents. For so many, can I get a job, keep a job, pay the bills by the end of the month, retire with dignity? For our students, can I pay off those student loans? For so many families, can I help get my family member off their opioid addiction? And for our farmers, can I keep my business thriving instead of having to look at bankruptcy because of this man's fragile ego that has prompted trade policy by tweet? So this is a moment in time for us to fight for the America we believe in. And in the America we believe in, you should only have to work one job to have a roof over your head and put food on the table. In the America we believe in, we will acknowledge a climate crisis and treat it with a sense of urgency. In the America we believe in, a woman will have power over her own body and the right to make decisions about what is in the best interest of her and her family. In the America we believe in, all people will have health care and cost will not be the barrier. In the America we believe in, we will pay our teachers their value, understanding how they are helping to raise our kids. And we will fight, because this is a fight born not only out of optimism and knowing what can be, unburdened by what has been. This is a fight not only for the soul of our country, born out of love of country, But this is a fight born out of knowing that this is so much worse than what we ever hoped it could be, and we are better than this. And I promise you, Iowa, we are going to win. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Kamala Harris, VP of the United States. Man, that sounds great. And now I am proud to introduce the next president of the United States, a man of integrity, values, a word that we don't hear much, empathy, and a lifelong dedication to our country. Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Biden.
Whatever he thinks, and I mean this in the bottom of my heart, I know I'm called middle class Joe, in Washington that's not meant as a compliment. It means you're not sophisticated. But I know why we're strong. I know why we have held together. I know why we are united. It's because there's always been a growing middle class. This guy doesn't have a clue about the middle class. Not a clue. Because, folks, when the middle class does well, when the middle class does well, the rich do very well and the poor have hope. They have a way up. He has no clue about what makes America great. Actually, he has no clue, period. But, folks, let me, you got it. Okay. But folks,
thank you, Joe. That was from the 2016 National Democratic Convention. And now here he is from South Carolina.
Battle for the soul of the United States of America. We're in an incredibly perilous moment, as all of you know. Winning means uniting America, not sowing more division and anger. It means not only fighting, but healing the country. We have to beat Donald Trump and the Republican Party, but here's the deal. We can't become like them. We can't become like them. We can't have an ever-ending war. Above all, it's time for America to get back up. The country is so ready. So ready. Once again, fight for the proposition that we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men and women are created equal, endowed by the Creator, with certain inalienable rights. We say it all the time, but we've never fully lived up to it. But we've never before, until this president, walked away from it. That's right. And it's the reason why Jim and I and all of us are in this. I believe with every fiber of my being that all men and women are created equal. You know, I saw it a few days ago in a town hall in Charleston, Jim. I spoke with Reverend Anthony Thompson, whose wife, Myra, was studying the words of her Bible with eight other parishioners and mother.
And now the latest from our candidate, Joe Biden, from the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. Take it away, Joe.
My fellow Americans, we're facing a formidable enemies. They include not only the coronavirus and the terrible impact on the lives and livelihoods, but also the selfishness and fear that have loomed over our national life for the last 3 years. And I choose those words advisedly, selfishness and fear. Defeating those enemies requires us to do our duty. And that duty includes remembering who we should be, who we should be.
We should be the America of FDR and Eisenhower, of Rosa Parks and Martin Luther King Jr., of Jonas Salt and Neil Armstrong. We should be the America that cherishes life, liberty, and courage. And above all, we should be the America that cherishes each other, each and every one of us. You know, we're a nation in pain. We must not let our pain destroy us. We're a nation enraged, but we cannot let our rage consume us. We're a nation that's exhausted, but we will not allow our exhaustion to defeat us. As president, it's my commitment to all of you to lead on these issues and to listen, because I truly believe in my heart of hearts, we can overcome. When we stand together, finally as one America, we'll rise stronger than we were before. We'll move that arc closer to justice. We'll reach out to one another. So speak out for one another. And please, please, do what's recently been happening. Take care of one another. This is the United States of America. There's never been anything we've been unable to do when we set our mind to do it and we've done it together. Together. United. That's where we are at our best. May God bless you all. And may God protect our troops. Thank you.
And now introducing Melissa Fox.
Wow. Thank you so much to everyone who put this amazing evening together. I put together some clips of our leaders inspiring us so that we would be ready to take on this battle. But it took hours and hours of preparation from Dennis, who is the most amazing MC cheerleader, pep rally god out there. So thank you, Dennis Bress, for hosting us through this evening and getting us ready for this convention. Everybody loves Dennis, that's for sure. Of course, I also want to take a minute to thank our speakers for making time to come on and get us all set. I never heard an electoral seder before, but that is what Dan Weitzman delivered, and it was incredible. And we are ready to go out from this bondage and head towards freedom. So thank you, Controller Weitzman. Now, Ada Briceno is the bravest of them all. She is a fighter, she is a leader, and she will lead this blue wave that is came in once in 18, and now it came back, and it's gonna be a tsunami. So thank you so much to Ada for coming here, and those words, thank you for supporting my campaign, and thank you for leading all of us Democrats. Congressman Lieu has been fighting for us in Congress for unbelievable fights, right? I mean, every time I think that he's gonna do something amazing, he just doubles it, right? And so now talking with us about the United States Post Office and what we need to do, I mean, he says it right away. What we need to do is get out and vote early. So to me, I wanted to just take a minute and think about what John Lewis faced. In the years that he was marching for voting rights, he had a heck of a lot more to challenge the country than the defunding of the U.S. Postal Service, right? They fought dogs, they fought security, they fought so much. And so for us, they set the battle plan. We need to organize. We need to get ready for phone banking and texting, and we have tools they could only have dreamt of with social media. And so we need to start at the bottom of the ballot and work up. That's great, Kathy. We need to take every single seat in Orange County and turn it blue. We know how to do this. We know how to organize. We know how to phone call. We know how to vote. And so we took the time to put this rally together, to listen to our leaders, to inspire us to do the hard work that needs to be done in the next 81 days. Now, we have 81 days until the close of the election, but the election really starts on October 5th. That's when we need to vote. That's when we need to get our ballots and have our ballot parties. And we're going to be doing them by Zoom. And we're going to be doing them on conference calls. And we're going to be texting. And we're going to be voting. But we're going to be helping our friends vote. And we're going to be helping our friends' friends vote. And we're going to be bringing new voters to the polls. New 18-year-olds. And new again, 78-year-olds and 88-year-olds. We need everyone. We need everyone to take back our country and vote for our values. We know what they are. We have them in our Democratic platform, and we're ready to set them in stone as soon as the Milwaukee convention starts. So thank you so much for everyone to be here today. The volunteers on my campaign who put this together, a huge thank you. And you know, volunteers don't just stick in one campaign. They work for everyone. So when you're calling and someone says, well, hey, I know I'm voting for Katie Porter, but who else? Or, hey, Joe's great, but who do you got for the Senate race? And so today we have Dave Min, who's here to support us, and we've got to get Dave Min in that Senate, and we have to get Lauren Johnson Norris on Irvine City Council, and she's here today. We've got to get Josh Newman back into that seat that they temporarily took away from him. And we need to keep all of our seven congressional candidates who won in 2018 continue on to a strong 2020. And not only that, but we have to look forward to 2022, because it's going to be a lot harder when we don't have a president on the ticket, when Joe's got us all turned around again and everything's looking good. So we have to keep strong. So I hope everyone is as inspired as I was. I want to thank, this was not an easy event to pull together. Oh, Harley Ruda. Yes, of course, Harley Ruda. And Gil Cisneros, sorry, did I leave them out? No way. And Tom Umberg, he was a surprise, of course. So we've got to get all of these people back in their seats, have them keep their seats, and we've seen what the consequences are. Real, live, life and death consequences. When we're seeing the numbers of illness in our country, the number of deaths in our country, and we are the only people who can protect our children, our grandparents, our families from standing up with science and moving forward. So a big, big thank you to everyone. I hope I didn't, I forgot to mention that we have with us Lou Lamont, the mayor of Malibu's just retired. And so he's with us today. And I think I got every, Kimberly Adams was running for Tustin City Council. She's gonna be a commissioner and then she's gonna run in 2022. And our candidates for Tustin are Lee Fink, Letitia Clark, and Becky Gomez. Oh, and of course, Cotty Petrie Norris in the assembly, so that me and Tom and Cotty and Sharon can all ride that silver plane up to Sacramento to represent you. So thank you so much. Oh, and thank you to Jeff and Trudy Opad, our Milwaukee delegates who brought us right to Milwaukee with them. Meredith Marquis, who keeps the field plan running. Allie Binder, who's an amazing chief of staff. If you want to volunteer for me, www.votemelissafox.com. You can sign up. But we are going to leave you loving this event and getting ready for some great Democratic convention and fight, fight, fight for the blue team. So peace out, everyone. And we are ready to go back to Dennis to kick us off for a good close.
Well, thank you very much, Melissa. Fox, you are our host, your entire team. You are running for the California State Assembly 8068. Thank you for everyone that participated to make this happen. And I'm just going to go off script here just for a moment. And as a team, Democrats kick butt. So anybody that we didn't mention, like, for example, Orange County Board of Supervisors, Sergio Contreras, right? Deidre Nguyen, right? We got some great candidates. So what we're going to do is we're all going to work collectively together to build that slate. And then when we phone bank and we talk to our neighbors, socially distancing, et cetera, we're going to go over the entire slate that we've handwritten ourselves. And we're going to take pictures of that slate and share it with our friends and neighbors so that they can vote that way. Because let's face it, a lot of people don't do the intensive work that we're used to doing with all these candidates. So that's vitally important that we support candidates up and down the ticket. So thank you for everybody.
Dennis, I did a bad thing.
What?
I did not write out my script. So yes, I forgot the amazing Deirdre Nguyen, who's going to win. Win. Right. Yep. And of course, Sergio Contreras, who we desperately needed the Board of Supervisors. But the most important person who I left off the list is the guy who's been running the show all night, who spent hours putting together these clips and running them and working with everyone. And that is my son, the incredible Maxim Fox, who has been a volunteer on my campaign his entire life. So I couldn't leave the show. I'm sorry for interrupting, but I have to shout out the incredible Max Fox, who's brought us the tunes, the clips, the go-tos, the graphics. Thank you so much. Thank you to Annie, Rachel, Luis, Daisy, Jesus, everyone. All right. Sorry about that.
Fantastic.
Always leaving someone out.
Nope, that was great. You covered it all, and Max did a great job. So let's wrap it up at this point. So grab a cocktail, enjoy the rest of the night, and let's get all Democrats, all of them, elected into the seats of power. So teamwork, go Democrats. That wraps up this 2020 pep rally for the 2020 Democratic Convention, live from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Have a great night, everyone, and be safe. Go Democrats, go USA, and peace out!
Power to the people!